Had a forced break because I didn't have the money to pay for my Adobe subscription, and it ended, so... And we're back! And today, we are at Leroy Hagen Community Park, and right now on the Sylph Road, it says nothing. It was previously a Slugma nest, and we know this park to be a nest. It's not one of the greatest nests. It's quite a large park, oddly, but it's not one of the greatest, and it doesn't really also have that many Pokestops, unfortunately. The west entrance had a higher percent of spawns, 3 in 30 minutes, 4 in 15, so... We are going to be investigating nests today. That's the whole plan. We've got this nest to investigate. I plan on also going and checking out this little nest. We're going to see what shows up. Last time somebody reported was on the 15th or the 16th migration, and they saw spawns of Mischievous. So after that, we are going to go up to this little community park. First place park, and a lot of people in the Vancouver Pokemon Go group have been saying that Charmanders are spawning there. So we're going to go there as well. After that, we are going to end it off at Pacific Community Park and then go down to Tech Center Community Park. They say right now that this Pacific Community Park is a Jigglypuff nest. If that's really what it is, we might not be there very long. And then we will head off to Tech Center Community Park. Last time it was a Wobbuffet nest, and right now nobody has reported it. So again, that's the plan for today. And if we have time, we will try to make our way down to the waterfront just to kind of, you know, take advantage of the water festival being at the waterfront. So I want to get down there. There's 2 days left on this event. It ends tomorrow at 1 p.m. So this episode is probably going to be a two-parter, just so you know. So enough about that. I haven't logged into Pokemon Go all day. It is to be my 7th day streak and my 7-day catch. So after it logs in here, hopefully we're in the range of a Pokestop. I'm going to turn on a lucky egg. Could be a nest of a mon I don't have, or it could be a nest of a mon that I need to evolve, or we could do that. So yes, we're in the range of a stop. That's perfect. So you can see here, it's kind of a big park. It's got 2 gyms and then 4 stops. So let's turn on not that. So first, during this water festival event, I had the lovely just random show up at my house. Excitement of a shiny Magikarp. It's a really low level, but hey, I have one. So, and it's not the greatest IVs, but hey, I have one. And then I hatched a Larvitar. I was pretty excited. So, right now, I have eggs at 0.4, 4.7, and 1.101. The 5K will definitely hatch. The 2K will definitely hatch. We do not know about the 10K. That will be a surprise if it does. My last 2 10Ks were not Dratinis. It was Pineco and Larvitar. Larvitar, I'm not disappointed about, obviously. So, lucky egg. I'm not going to do an incense because... Alright, 7-day spin. Come on, don't do this to me. Don't have poopy service. Okay, I'm going to wait for the white thing to stop spinning. Okay, so... Hey, don't do that crap to me. Thank you. Ooh, upgrade! Yes, I can get my Porygon too! Upgrade and many much Pokeballs. Thank you. All right. Well, guaranteed item. Thank you, Niantic, for doing something good. All right. Let's go and check this out. So far, it looks like Ooh, there's a Sneasel. Why does that not have to be over here? We're gonna ignore it, because that's not the purpose of today's episode. The purpose of today's episode is to investigate nests. So far, it looks like a Merrill nest. Two Merrills. I would doubt it's a Spinarak nest. Could be, but let's go investigate. Okay, so we have a ferret right when you come into the park. Not the greatest, but it's a ferret. Being a rather difficult little ferret. Not even that high of CP, really, in my opinion. I'm really just trying to get my 7-day catch, and I'm not wasting it on this now. Come up with a new philosophy to save balls. If I've wasted 5 already, especially if I've gone to great, if I've wasted 3 and berries, back out. Better to save your stuff than to sit there and get irritated at the fact that you can't catch it, and then you waste 5 more balls just to catch it. It's not worth it. Ooh, a 10KA, good. The 5K hatching. I'm hoping for a fan fee. I will go with the Tyrogue though. That's fine. As long as its appraisal is HP. Yes! Yes! I don't care. Ugh, I want to do this right now. Oh my god, I want to do this right now. I will wait because I want to complete my decks along with getting my Dragonite when I evolve my Dratini. So, Gen 1 decks will have to wait. Oh, but that's so exciting! Gave me my 7th day streak catch, and then we got the Chinchou. There is another Chinchou on the sidings, but so is Merrill. But I haven't seen a Merrill yet, though. And then we got that Quillfish. Pretty high CP, but, you know, not the greatest IVs. We are gonna follow this way, because we are going to finally get this one. We think, or I think, it's a Merrill nest. So I want to come this way, check out this side, and then I do want to go to the other one on that side to see what it is, to see what it has, and to maybe see what spawns along that trail. So let's go get this Merrill.
here. CP74 should be pretty fairly easy to catch. Okay, there was a second one. Maybe it's over this way. So 110, a little higher, or 101, a little higher CP. I don't really need Merrills right now, but again, we're investigating nests. And if this is a Merrill nest, this is a Merrill nest. But as of now, there's no more Merrills on the nearby. But that also could be because we're on this side of the park and showing everything that could be in that direction. So, like I said, we're gonna head on that way and go around towards that front corner and see if anything spawns while we're on this back trail. It's not necessarily on, and we're gonna go that way. And it should go to the yellow gym, and then we can go back up. So, we're gonna spin the stop. And head on our way around that way. Well, I mean, the sidewalk along the street going that way will loop us around, but it doesn't loop around inside of the park. Single instinct player here, ruling this one gym. I will leave him be. Probably doesn't have a lot of gyms anyways. I mean, it's not even on the nearby. You sit. Had to set the camera down. That was a horrible throw and it missed, and that's fine. So if you can't tell, we're on the back end of the park, right by the road. Yes. I think that's my fourth Mantine. Okay, well, we got that Merrill down there. So let's go get it. Okay, so there's the Merrill. Didn't even have to walk all the way over here. So I'm gonna say that it's a Merrill nest. We've gotten one at almost every poke stop so far, except for the entrance one. I need to take off this jacket. I'm sweating up a storm. Spin this stop. 2K egg. So that's a 2K and a 10K. I didn't incubate my other one. Do I have? I have one more incubator. I'm going to use it on the 10K, of course. All right, and we got that other 2K at one, so it'll hatch soon. Okay, so we're back at the front of the park here. We're gonna let the plus spin that stop, but nothing else is showing up. So I think it's fair to say that it's a Merrill nest, and since I don't really need any more Merrills, so I think that's fair to say. we're gonna head on to the next place. See you there. Hatching right when we get to this other park. A Togepi! Sorry, Zoe, two dots. I know you're looking for one. Okay, so we got to this park, and of course the poke stop is down at the beginning of the street down here. And again, this is another one of those, you know, super tiny, right in the middle of a neighborhood. A super immaculate, gorgeous fucking neighborhood. I guarantee you these are quite a few million-dollar homes, I guarantee it. Ooh, a Magikarp. Be a shiny? Nope. 111. Okay. Magikarp, Remoraid, and they disappear. Then they stop. A Remoraid, Goldene. And a Murkrow! So we're gonna get this Remoraid. I've had quite a few Remoraids show up at my house during the event. That was such a lucky throw. Okay, Remoraid caught. I've had a lot of them show up at my house. I even had an Octolily show up. I think it was on the first day of the event. We're gonna catch this Goldene as well. And I think for this little park, we're just gonna walk around and then we'll head on to the much larger, more important park. Right now, I'll catch any Magikarp. I only have one Gyarados. They're not very common around here. Oddly. Alright, well, that puts me at 191. Still got, you know, 309 to go. Right? 209? 309? Whatever. Too many. Let's go spin that stop one last time, and then we'll head out to the next park. That's close enough. All right. Now, this place was supposed to be a Charmander sighting, is what people had said, but I'm not seeing any, and we just came back from the poke stop. I mean, I'll walk down there again, but of course, you know, right when I get ready to leave, that's when he shows up on the sighting. We're gonna walk back down to the poke stop to see if he's maybe down at the poke stop, because that's really the only place I would think he would be. And I'm not recording any of this because I kind of stopped recording and forgot. Still not seeing any kind of Charmander. He's just on the sighting, that's it. He could be anywhere. I guess we can make one more loop. It's not the end of the world. New homes, right next to a Charmander. Okay, so 493 CP. Let's see if I can do this. All right, okay. So we got what we came here for. I mean, even if it's just one, we got what we came here for. Now, we're going to head on to the Pacific Community Park and see if it is indeed a Clefairy nest, and if it is, then we're probably not going to stay there long at all. We'll see you there.
Okay, so right now we're at Columbia Tech Center Park, and it doesn't really show as registered as any kind of specific nest. Last time it was a Wobbuffet nest. The park is really narrow. It just kind of goes straight back and it loops around and comes back to the front. So we're gonna make those loops and check out what's here.
Okay, so at this double stop right up here at the front, we're gonna spin these first. No other item at all today, just that seven streak one. So we got a Meryl and a Shellder. And then another Shellder, well, that's down the street. And then we got the Meryl right here. There's a Squirtle up there. And the supposed Magikarp right here as well, but along with a Horsea. So let's go get the Squirtle first. And then we'll walk back this way and loop around to the other side to see if maybe the Magikarp's on that other side. Again, with those Goldeens. What is up with those stupid Goldeens? Okay, a Hoot Hoot. Haven't seen one of those for a while. You know, because of the water festival and all. It said the Squirtle fled. Oh. Whoops, whoops. Hoot Hoot. Okay, so even though it just said Pokemon fled, we know that after that, if it did indeed actually flee, you have a minute and a half to get to it before it completely despawned. So we're just right here. It shouldn't be too difficult. Okay, well, there he is. I'm gonna spin this other stop. And I'm gonna give this a whirl. Okay, well, that was rather difficult. Jeez Louise. And I would like to say, you know, because it had okay IVs, but that never really plays into the whole whether they're easy to capture or not. So we're gonna turn around, because this is really kind of the end of the park here. I'm gonna let Plus get the stop really quick, and the other one, while it turns blue, before I get too far. Okay.
So that was my first time trying the green screen realistic scene thing. I don't know if it'll be a regular. I assume when I get to editing, it's going to be one of those things that takes a long time. So we're gonna walk up to the stops over here, and then we're going to actually head our way into the park to see what's there. Of that poke stop, and it's not a Magikarp anymore, it's a Staryu, because I guess I waited too long. I think geese are probably my favorite birds. I know they're mean, but I like the way they fly, it's just really cool. It's nothing to do with the fact that they fly in a V. Okay, so we have another 2KM egg hatching. I have no idea what it could be. Another Togepi! Are you kidding me right now? It took me so long. Well, it didn't really take me so long. It took me a while to finally get a Togepi, and then once I finally got a Togepi, I didn't even know they come out of 2K eggs, but sorry again, Zoe. So CP300. Huh. And I almost have enough candies now too. 37. Huh.
Okay, so it shows across the street that there's, well, so we have the Chinchou there, but it shows that there's a Magikarp over there. They said that there was two. So we're gonna cross the street and go catch these Magikarps. Ooh, and a Natu. And a Meryl. And a Wooper. Okay, let's get the Plus helping out. Plus will get the stop and the Natu while I get that. Okay, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. He gets a stop. I will spin it myself then. And I will grab this Wooper. So sometimes the Plus really, since the update, Plus has been really weird. Has anybody else with a Plus noticed that after the update it's been weird? It just does the weirdest stuff. And it's not consistent. There's the other Magikarp. Okay. Okay, that's pretty easy. And the Magikarp. I don't really care what CP it is. My highest one right now is 162. And that's higher than my first one. I think my first one was like 147. 203 candies. 197 to go. Okay, so I think we are done with this park for the time being. And I think for now, we should head on to the waterfront before it gets too late. Well, I don't really care if it gets dark, but nevertheless, we should get down there before it gets too late. So, once again, we'll see you there.